It's me again, talking about my backpack and everything I took with me on Entre Les Illoma Trail in the winter with a lot of rain. Yeah, it sucked. Okay, I'll start with explaining everything that's on the outside of the pack. So this is the Osprey Aura 50 liters, which is an awesome pack. It's a perfect size. You can see I left the hood off because I think it's a little bit heavy and I want to go like a little bit ultralight. And I don't really use the pockets because I think this one and the side pockets are big enough. But I do have a very big duty bag where I try to keep everything in that I need to reach easily. And it's at the top of my bag so I can easily reach it. So I've got my trekking poles. I only use one because with my other hand I was holding the umbrella, so I should have left one at home, but trekking poles, love these. Decathlon, awesome. This is the fitness pass from Decathlon. It's like 2 euros, but I use it to do yoga outside, and when I go winter backpacking, this is my extra foam pad to lay on top of my other pad, which I'll show you later. Then I've got my Nalgene, my water close by, and my umbrella. Oh my god, it's broken. It's broken, then. Oh no, no, I'm breaking it. My umbrella. It was a last minute decision to bring this. I was like, well, my rain jacket will be more than enough. But then, like the last 5 minutes, I was like, oh well, fuck it, I'll just bring it. I was so, so happy I did. So happy about that. Wow. On the pockets, cookies. Put this one back. And some binder clips for drying your clothes, which I didn't because it was raining. And the other one, I usually put my phone or... Okay, there's nothing in here. Oh my god, I forgot the outside pockets. Okay, a spoon. I always put it in here because otherwise I lose it. So this is the spot for my spoon, I guess. Sawyer squeeze. Water filtration. That's a good thing to have. I hate the bag. My rain jacket. I love this. Just basic Decathlon stuff. All you need. And then I made a mistake. Usually I put my tent inside my backpack, which I did on the second day when the tent was soaked, and then all the inside of my backpack was soaked. So I learned a lesson and now I'll put it on top when it's wet. This is the Nemo Hornet two-person tent. Two persons because I like the room and it's not that much heavier. I've got a video explaining what I think about this tent and also the other tents I have. So if you're interested, I'll link it here. Okay. I always forget, but you have to unfasten this every time. You take everything out your back, and I always forget, but now I did it. Good thing. Quit somebody. So I was always wearing this jacket on Entre Les Illoms because it was
cold.
It is a Gore-Tex jacket that's insulated, it's like kind of thick, and it keeps me nice and comfy. There is a hood, but I didn't take it with me for extra weight. The whole jacket weighs a lot, it's not like an ultralight hiking jacket stuff. But right now it's too hot. So I have these two bottles with me, a liter and a half a liter Nalgene, and then I have the Sawyer bag, which is also half a liter. So I have 2 liters with me. By the way, I love this bottle. This is one of the best purchases I ever did hiking. Not just because it carries your water, but because you can fill it with hot water, and when it's cold at night, you can put it at your feet and it's so nice and warm. And then in the morning, you can drink coffee of it. Coffee in it, and it's so easy to wash. I mean, you just have to put some water in, shake it, pour it out, maybe do it again, and it's clean, and that's so, so handy. That was a lot of explaining. I need some more water. I need some wine, actually. This is such a nice spot. Awesome here. This is my food bag. This is not my actual food bag. This is my puffy. Well, because I ate my food. But this is kind of the size and the bag I use. If you want to know what food I brought with me, you can check it out in a video from the planning of Entre-les-Elan. Okay, this is my ditty bag. There is rope in here for, I don't know what, a lighter? It's a spare one, because my jet boil has an ignition button, so I don't need this, but backup, of course, and like when you want to pull the fire. Then some duct tape wrapped around a cart, which I cut in half. And my new pocket knife. It's tiny and it has scissors. So tiny, so tiny. We'll see how it goes. If I don't like it, I can always go back to my email. The other side is my floss, toothpaste, which is empty, toothbrush. I like the smaller one because it fits everywhere, so I think it's easier to use. And a hair tie, big hair tie. Okay. The big pocket has my first aid kit. And this is everything that's in my first aid kit. My headlamp, the Petzl Bindi, it's a new one and I like it. It has a tiny battery, it's like only 2 or 3 hours of light, so it goes down very quickly. This is for when I sprain my ankle. Hand sanitizer. Hygiene and Corona, my massive power bank, 2000 milliamps, because I like watching movies, listening to music. Thermarest, first aid kit for Thermarest, if it makes sense. A space blanket, half one, for women stuff, and some money. I always bring some cash. And this is my secret spot, and now everybody knows where I keep my extra cash. This is my Thermarest. I love the valve. I love how small it packs. I love how lightweight it is. But I'm cold on this thing when it's like colder than 5 degrees Celsius. My sleeping bag is -9 degrees Celsius, and this thing is not warm enough. I don't know. It's a mystery. But I paid a lot of money for it, so I mean. Ah, toilet paper. Don't forget toilet paper. Yeah. In the cold, I definitely want enough fuel, so I'll bring the extra. Usually I just use these because they're more cost effective and measured. I could do 2 weeks with this one. With the jet boil, it's pretty fuel efficient, so that's enough. This is my jet boil. I broke this and there's no replacements anywhere. Do I like the jet boil? I love the jet boil. Yeah, I like to do big cooking, so I like a good pot that doesn't burn. I know it's heavy, but it's so easy to use. I love it. Okay, last but not least, my clothes. I'll put these on my thing. This is my dry bag. What's in here? My sleeping bag and my clothes and my pillow. So in here I put everything that is clean, and when things are dirty or wet I just shove them down in my bag. This is my insulator if I want coffee. Like on the train, I'll just bring this with me with coffee inside. It's probably not worth bringing. It's just a random sock, by the way, a thick one. Oh, I gotta take everything out. Ta-da! Okay, this is a Cumulus, custom made. Pertex Quantum. Okay, so this is the Panyam custom made. I filled it a little bit more, and I mean you can customize everything, but it's basically a down sleeping bag that's good till minus 9 degrees Celsius. It'll keep me warmer, it's like just a bit freezing. Yeah, if I'm ever gonna do like winter expeditions or something, I'll need a bigger sleeping bag. But this one is awesome. I do like to be super warm when camping. I hate being cold. Definitely like at night when you wanna rest. And this is really my safe space. And yeah. I'm happy I invested in a good bag. I paid nearly 400 euros for this bag. And then what I wore hiking is this. I'll be a fashion model now.
Samurai sword on my back. You don't know how to act. Maybe you should relax.
When hiking, I usually wear something like this. This is my red Nike polyester t-shirt and my Fjällräven Nika pants. They're awesome with lots of pockets. In my pockets, I usually have my hanky, my earphones, a face mask close by so I can easily put it on, and my tracker. I'm also wearing this grey long sleeve t-shirt and my Loa Gore-Tex hiking shoes.
So, the Kesha socks, and I have my winter jacket as well.
For sleeping,
I do have a liner, it's incredibly soft, and it keeps my sleeping bag clean, and I think it's way more hygienic. And then I had two sleeping pants with me. I had merino wool leggings and thick fleece leggings. For the first two nights I only used these because it was still in the positive temperatures at night, so this was more than enough. And then for the other nights I had the fleece pants, which I loved. And then also like on the second day I wore these pants together with my hiking pants to be warmer during the day. For sleeping, I wore a t-shirt and a sweater, and I'll interchange this depending on what I want to wear and how cold it is. And I wear these socks. Underwear, I did bring an extra pair. And then the Kesha socks, I like these best for hiking in. And an extra hanky. And my pillow, Decathlon of course. This was everything I took with me on Ontoulaz-les-Lom. It's a great trail, by the way. It's very quiet. It's 3 days of just nature in Belgium. And if it's not raining. If it's raining, it's wet.
Benji. Benji has been waiting so patiently. Oh. But it's dinner time for him, so we'll go home now.
Angelica, sit.
Hey, my kitchen is fine. Okay,
call him.
It's not falling over.
Oh. No, it's going slow. Okay, my backpack is toppling over. Okay, let's do this again because we don't want everybody seeing online. That's how influencers show you what's not true. Ha 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 ha.